Hi everyone, my name is Raya Routsip and I'm a teacher with Toronto and Region Conservation Authority. And I am so excited that one of the projects I get to be involved with is the Meadoway project. Now, if you're not familiar with what this is, it's essentially, in a nutshell, converting a long strip of hydro corridor in Scarborough into a long meadow habitat. So rather than having turf grass underneath the hydro lines, we want to have beautiful native wildflower species, which then create this fantastic meadow habitat for urban wildlife in Toronto. This project goes through many different communities, and we want to make sure that there is community involvement in the project. So my role as a teacher is to connect with schools, teachers, students in those classes to have them be engaged in the Meadoway as well. What happens is that we actually provide the classes that are taking part with grow kits in the winter. So pots, a tray of pots, soil, a spray bottle, and sometimes grow lights as well, and then two different species of wildflower seeds. So in this case, we have black-eyed Susan and wild bergamot. We provide these to the classes in the winter. Students will plant the seeds and actually take care of these plants as they grow for a couple of months into seedlings that can then be planted into the Meadoway. So what happens in the spring is that the students will come on a walking field trip. These are schools that are right in that Meadoway community, so they can walk right to the Meadoway, and they bring half their plants, plant them right in the ground there to be part of that restoration work that's happening, and also take part in some other activities to learn about why it's so important to have native species in our habitats, and find out about different animals that live in the Meadoway. And then the other part of this program is that we actually visit the schools in the spring as well. So the other half of the plants that students had grown get planted into the schoolyard, so that we're kind of emphasizing that connection. It's not just about that one strip of wildlife habitat that exists, but also the schoolyards, the backyards, that these are all part of the bigger picture. And there is that connection. The same bee that might visit the Meadoway could also visit their schoolyard with these plants in place. This year, things have been happening a little bit differently, but students were growing the plants in their classroom, and now some of the trays are in student homes or in teacher homes as the students are taking care of the plants. And we actually have a special guest in today, which I'm so excited about. She is one of the teachers at one of these Meadoway schools, and she'll be sharing some information about the experience that students have been having in this program, both last year, this year, and how the Meadoway plants are now being used to green up these spaces in the Meadoway area. I also want to thank her young son, our budding cinematographer, for doing the filming. She's coming to us from her backyard, and he was willing to volunteer to film her her piece. So thank you very much. And without further ado, take it away, Tanya.
Hi there, I'm Tanya Eyre. I'm a teacher and teacher librarian at General Creer Public School in Toronto, in Scarborough. And our school is so thrilled to have partnered with Toronto Region Conservation Authority last year and this year for the Meadoway. And I just wanted to show you this year, our students in several of our classes planted some native wildflower and grass seeds to participate in the Meadoway. So we planted late February, early March, and for the March break and then following also the lockdown, several students and staff offered to take the plants home. So you can see how well they've done in different staff and student homes. And we're gonna be excited to get planting. So this year, due to the pandemic, unfortunately we can't plant in the Meadoway, but we're very excited to extend the reach of the native plants and pollinators to our yards, our local yards. And several of our students are going to be able to tune into live planting sessions as well, so they can still participate. They love getting their hands dirty in the soil and planting the seeds, and they've done a fantastic job of growing the plants. So here's a black-eyed Susan. And you can see you can estimate the depth of the plant. And I've dug a hole that's a little bit too deep. So we'll just fill it up a little. There we go. And that should be perfect. There we go. So we planted our first Meadoway plant, and I'm going to continue. Last year, the students were able to grow their plants in their classrooms, and they brought half of all the grown plants to the Meadoway, and we planted there, which was an awesome educational experience that connected so much to so much of our curriculum. And then we were very equally thrilled to plant in our schoolyard. So we welcome two Toronto Region Conservation Authority teachers to our school, and they helped us plant. They helped all the classes that participated to plant the native wildflowers and grasses in our schoolyard. And this year, although we can't do that, we're still very thrilled to participate. And we're so thrilled at the growth. Look at that. It's amazing how well they've done. And perfect. There we go. And I'm going to get planting. I'm going to continue. But thank you for joining us. Thank you for participating. And we look forward to many more partnerships and collaborations. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much, Ms. Ayer, for sharing the student experience with the Meadoway Project. And thank you to your son for being such a great assistant in the field. We really appreciate that. So we just got to see one of the Grow Kids in action and how they can help play a role in students playing a role in greening up the Meadoway and greening up this local green space. We really want the Meadoway to be a community-powered green space, and that means making sure that students are active in the project. Now, I wanted to share a little bit of information about some of the specific plant species that students have been growing in their classrooms and that are being planted in the Meadoway. And we'll start off with the one that Miss Ayer was planting, which is Black-Eyed Susan. So this is what it looks like when it flowers later in the summer. And just as a note about the seeds that students received in their grow kits, the seeds for the Black-Eyed Susan flowers that they received were actually harvested from Black-Eyed Susan plants in the Meadoway. So they've kind of gone full circle. The seeds were harvested in the fall and dried out and stratified, which means that they were put in the fridge in a cold space for the winter, and then distributed to classrooms for students to plant and grow. When the Black-Eyed Susan plant is young, then it has these very fuzzy leaves. Well, it has fuzzy leaves when it's older as well, but if you notice a plant that has these fuzzy leaves but no flowers yet, then you're probably looking at Black-Eyed Susan. One of the other plants that students have been growing, we've been planting in the Meadoway, is common yarrow. So this is what common yarrow looks like as a seedling. It has these very frilly leaves. And when common yarrow is grown, then it has white flowers, very small blossoms. And what's interesting is, well, these flowers, they actually attract all kinds of pollinators. They have a really distinctive smell, so bees and butterflies and other flies. But the leaves themselves, they actually have a bit of a bitter taste. And so mammals don't tend to prefer the leaves of the common yarrow, but they do provide really great coverage when animals are looking for hiding places and nooks and crannies in a meadow. One more plant I wanted to talk with you about is this one here. So I don't know if you can guess what this plant is. When it's older grown, then it has a purple flower, light purple color. And if I was able to transmit the smell of this leaf to you through the screen, it smells so good, then you might have a better hint. This is wild bergamot. And as I mentioned, it smells just lovely. I find it has a bit of an oregano smell to it myself, which I love. And when it flowers, then the bees can't actually access the nectar through the top of the flower. So what they will do is they'll chew a little hole in the bottom of the flower to access the nectar and get the nectar. And it works really well to get the nectar through this little hole at the base of the flower. So that's our friend wild bergamot, one of my favorites. Now, I want to thank you so much for learning about the school program that we have in the Meadoway. And if you are a teacher and you're looking to get involved, if you're a teacher at a school that's along the Meadoway at any point, please do get in touch with us through the website. So it's themeadoway.ca, and you can look at the Get Involved button there. As we work on the different sections, we will be wanting to engage students that are in those areas for the walking field trips and being a part of greening up this space. So thank you very much. It's been great to have you. Take care, everybody.